Episode 4 of Road to Varsity is a go, and we're in for a long one.
Absolutely. We got girls cross country as they're training up for the state meet, which is at Carrollton this Saturday, so they're putting in a lot of hard work and trying to win another state championship.
We heard that this is one of their toughest practices of the year, but we're really excited. All three of us, not much experience in the running game, but we're excited here to start.
And just so you know, we have heard that it's approximately 3 miles in total. Not counting warm-up, so you guys will see the aftermath. We'll take a couple videos of us beforehand talking normally and stuff, and then we'll take videos of us after, and we'll probably not be talking too much.
Yeah,
but
it'll probably be us on the floor struggling.
Yeah.
That's great entertainment for you guys, and we'll see you on the trails.
Let's head to practice. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take it. I got no love for the fakeness. If you want to play tough and want to hate this, I'll always show up. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take it. Got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
All right, now we're joined by Coach Fuca. And Coach, you guys had a long season, really, really like a great season. So what have you seen from your girls?
Yeah, it's been a really awesome season. Our girls have run incredibly well this season. We're actually in contention for the state title this year, which is always really exciting. We've had a few years where we've had some good top girls, but to have a team this deep has been really awesome.
Getting to join your team, we've seen firsthand like the team camaraderie that's been built. What's it like having such a strong chemistry? And also, how does it help you guys in your races with such a grueling race or sport?
Yeah, I mean, this year the girls have done a really good job of working together. We spend a lot of time together. You kind of make friends whether you want to or not. They've been really good at racing together as well, which is really helpful.
And with all that time spent together, do you have a favorite memory, at least this year, with all the girls?
I mean, honestly, like every day, something new, funny happens. My slogan for this year is you should be running. So that's kind of our inside joke of the year. But it's been a really good season.
And coming up this weekend, you guys have the biggest race of the year.
Yep.
What's the anticipation like that? How do you feel about the girls?
Yeah, I think we're definitely ready. We'll start to taper our workout. So this is our last really hard workout of the season, which they're excited about. So we'll do some shorter runs this week, and then we'll start doing some speed work on Thursday to kind of get their bodies ready for that race on Saturday.
Our practice today, we're doing a 10-minute warm-up, and then we're doing 4 hills, and then we're doing a hard mile on the track and a cool down.
Warm-up's the best part.
So that practice, we're not even finished with it yet. The hardest thing I've ever done, it's harder than any work I've ever done. They're doing 4 laps up around the hill and back down. We each only made 2 separate variations. You guys will see the footage from around the corner. Oh my gosh, that was insane.
I think if I pushed myself any harder, you wouldn't be seeing me standing up.
Not at all.
Yeah, you got. That was brutal. I mean, you're kind of going the fly and then you get to that hill. That thing just never ends.
It just kills you.
The crazy thing is, though, the girls legitimately, like my pace when I would hit the hill would slow down by probably 3/4. They would just go up around and like nothing happened. They're still going right now. Some of the most impressive stuff, that after this, they got a mile. We'll see how that goes. We're doing the mile too. This one is going to be the final push, but wow. Hardest practice I've ever done.
All of our heads are just pounding right now.
I drank electrolytes going into this, and still, I think I'm gonna need a couple days of just bed rest and soup.
I know we're gonna wake up tomorrow morning and our entire legs are just gonna be.
Oh yeah, no, it's not even gonna close. Frazier, film yourself, just flip it around. Yeah, he ran one. He ran some of one.
In Crocs.
Yeah, in Crocs, which is very impressive. Show them the Crocs. There yeah, so at least they're camo blended in. They couldn't see his feet. But now we're gonna hit the mile, but first we're gonna just watch them run back and then we'll regroup. So, see you then.
Ready, go!
I tapped out. I flat out couldn't make it, man. Right here, just killed me. This stamina is insane.
I decided to call it when I was somewhat ahead. Finished, I think, third or fourth place through 800. Then I felt, I felt the cramp right here, and that's when I knew if I kept running, I'd be last. So I didn't want that to happen, but props to the girls.
He did the entire mile.
Okay, and he did
the entire mile.
I think Nitin gets extra points for his shoes because those are good runner shoes. Those are valid. Those get like at least a point. He really committed to the runner aesthetic.
No runner would wear those On Cloud shoes. So.
Yeah. Minus 3 points for the On Cloud.
We're adding points to the award.
I say we go Palmer, Nitin, Alex. Palmer 7, Nitin 4.
Nitin? Yeah. So basically he wouldn't be getting
five is crazy.
Five is the shoe.
Palmer has a watch.
That could be plus points.
Oh, but it's an Apple Watch. It's an Apple Watch. Mine is Palmer.
So we're gonna give Palmer first place. He gets a 7.
Thank you.
Sorry. We said that because he did most of the workout and he did the whole mile.
And his clothes and
he did the warm up. All right. And then Nitin's second and he gets a 4. We liked his shoes. They're very runner core. That's why we give him the extra point. And then, Alex, you're in last with a 3. You're on clouds, just weren't really.
He wore those same shoes he did volleyball, and they fell off for the record. So that's just a definite issue.
Also, you did not. You tried to sprint ahead at the end. That was pretty embarrassing.
And now this is us post-cross country. Definitely a brutal workout, guys. How we feeling?
Yeah, that was tough.
Yeah. I couldn't even sniff the finish line.
I know, Alex and I, we tried. Palmer was a trooper here, finished out most of it.
But I just wanted to see what my mile time could be because I haven't ran a mile in a long time. Don't plan on doing it anytime soon. We'll push through.
I'm pretty sure the 2.5 miles is the furthest I've ever ran, like legitimately.
Oh, no, 100%. I think I was on pace for like a 6:20 mile, and then my cramping started, and that's when I called it. But
which, it wasn't on camera, but after that first lap, when we're running past the boys' team, I go, by the third lap, they're going to be behind me, and I was right. By the third lap, they'd both given up, and I was ahead. So, hey, sometimes the tortoise does beat the hare. You know, I was able to beat both them, finish it. But honestly, I honestly kind of enjoyed it.
Yeah, the girls gave us all their ratings. We'll pop them up right here. As we see our new standings, things might be shifting up, getting closer, getting tighter here as we head into winter sports rolling around the corner.
Yeah. We got swimming or cheerleading next, so stay tuned for that.
So many options.
Yeah, we got a variety of stuff to hit up next.
Yeah. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. It's always a pleasure to do it, but hopefully you guys enjoyed watching it as well, and we will see you next time with the other sports. And also make sure to stay tuned to the girls' updates. I know they've got the state race coming up, and that's really exciting.
Yeah. Go Cats.
Go Cats.